already found you. You just got to find God. I want to tell you, brother, whenever you find God, that's a glorious moment. I just praise God to the highest, you know, that He is the one. He is my master. He is my physician. He is my everything. Yes. Praise God.
Come
glory,
on,
hallelujah.
Brother.
Hey, I tell you, He is all in all. I tell you, and I give it to Him, brother, because, hey, He is the one that loves me. He is the one that gave it all for me on that cross.
Yes. Woo. Praise God. Amen. Well, your pastor must just turn you all loose to obey the Lord.
Why? I'd obey the Lord even if He didn't.
Amen.
Because, hey, it's all about the Lord, you know.
Amen.
It ain't about us. It's all about God, you know. If we can't do His will, then people say, well, what are you supposed to do? Are you supposed to sit here? No. I'm not going to sit there if God calls me up to say, well, you go and say this word to these people. Hey, I'm going to go say it. I ain't going to sit there and be like a dummy on a log.
Yeah. You mean you would disrupt service if God told you to move?
You got that right,
Amen.
Brother. Because, hey, if it comes from God, oh, yes.
You ain't disrupting, are you? If it's God, you're in order. Amen.
That's right.
Praise God. The Lord is good. Amen.
Amen, brother.
Amen, brother. Well, go ahead. We obey the Lord. I mean, whatever you want.
You know, a lot of people sits on their couches with a remote in their hand every Sunday. You know, they'll say, well, I'll think about it. I'll think about going to church. I'll think about going next Sunday. I'll think about going tonight. Don't think about it. Get up and do it. Be a doer, not a sayer, you know. What's the use of sitting there saying it? Get up and do it. Because, hey, God wants you to make that first step. And He's right there with you all the way. You know, if you can't make that first step, then, hey, God ain't going to push you to do it because, hey, that's your free will. That's what He gives you, and He won't mess with free will.
Ooh, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm telling you.
I tell you, I feel Him all over me tonight.
Amen.
I praise His holy name for everybody. I think that's about all He wants me to say tonight.
Praise the Lord. All right, brother. Know that I love you. Hope to see you soon. And be sure to give everyone there a big hug for me.
Sure, brother. We love you. God bless you, brother.
Hey, God bless, bub. Bye-bye.
Ooh,
praise the Lord. Amen. I tell you what, now, the Lord is moving not only here in Crossville, Tennessee, but all over the world. He's God everywhere, ain't He? Man, I wish I could have been there. Praise God, it sounds like they've had a Holy Ghost hold down. You know what I mean? Praise God, they just having them a good time in the Lord right there in I believe that's up in Knox County, Kentucky, amen, up there in God's country. That's what we call it, where they have to pump the sunshine in, amen. All right, praise the Lord. You're listening to the Gospel Music Jukebox. Hey, I'm your host, Evangelist Eddie Chaney. You can call in live during the program. We'd love to hear from you. We just encourage you to obey the Lord. That's what we want you to do. First and foremost, whether it be a testimony, a word, a song, we just want you to obey the Lord. Amen. All right, we'll be right back. Once again, you're listening to the Gospel Music Jukebox. Be blessed in Jesus' name.
John, oh John, what did you say?
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I'll meet you there on the crowning day.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready.
No,
walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Someday we'll rise and shine in glory.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Till then I'll tell the gospel story.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready.
No,
walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Hey. that trumpet blow.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Till Jesus said it's time to go.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready.
No.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John.
Hello, God bless you all, and I love you all. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. I was calling in to say a prayer for healing. There's some of us who need healing. But first, I wanted to say part of the cost of following Jesus Christ is denying sin. Sin separates men from God, Isaiah 59:1-2. If we have sin in our life, we can't go through the gates into the city. We can't be where Jesus is. We've got to get sin out of our life. That's the cost of following Jesus Christ. He said, go and sin no more. Go and sin no more, or something worse might happen to you. Ephesians chapter 5 says we shouldn't have a hint of fornication or sin in our lives. We've got to get sin out. A lot of people play around with sin. They don't truly repent. And if we're truly going to follow Jesus, we have to truly repent and say no to sin. It's a very serious matter. Now I want to go ahead and I want to pray for healing. Father, I love you with all my heart, mind, and soul. I want to come to you in prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you so much for sending Jesus to die for our sins and to die on the cross for our sicknesses and diseases. It says in Isaiah 50, it says in the book of Isaiah that we are healed by the stripes wounds and in the name of Jesus Christ, Isaiah 53:4-5. And I'm claiming our healing right now in the name of Jesus. Jesus died for our sins to set us free from sins. He also died to set us free from sicknesses and diseases. Psalm 103, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities and who heals all of your diseases. This is just saying, Father, right here, just like it says in Isaiah 53:4-5, Jesus died on the cross not only for our iniquities and sins, to forgive us from them, and we repent and say no to them, but to also heal our diseases by the stripes, wounds, in the name of Jesus Christ. With the power that you use to make the sun, the stars, the earth, the sky, all that you've created, with your might, with your healing power, I ask for that power to flow into our bodies right now from the top of our heads to the bottom of our feet, and I claim our healing, whoever needs healing, and by the stripes, wounds, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, I'm totally healed of all those food allergy problems. I praise you and thank you for that. The Apostle Clovis Robinson is totally healed of his diabetes, any problems with his kidneys. I know that his kidneys are healed. They're like new, and I'm claiming his healing in the name of Jesus, all of our healings, because you are a healer. And for those who need set free from sin, I pray for them right now that they will be healed, that Jesus will come into their hearts and lives with his love, with your love, and they will be able to say no to sin and truly repent. We have to truly repent and say no to sin. Thank you, Father, so much for healing and for helping us all. I love you and pray this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Standing there at the Red Sea, with Pharaoh's army closing in behind. The fearful crowd drew wary and began to plead, Moses, have you led us here to die? But you did it again, right on time. Roll back the water deep and wide before they call it quits and said the last amen. You showed up just in time, but Lord, you did it again. Boys were were taken to an angry king, to an idol god that had refused to bow. Walking to a fiery furnace, I can hear one say, our God is able to deliver us somehow. But you did it again, right on time. The poor man in the fire that blew their minds before they called it quits and said the last amen. You showed up just in time, but Lord, you did it again. You're not fearful of the furnace or frightened by the sea. Lord, you never get too busy to ever rescue me. You did it again, right on time. You rolled back the water deep and wide before they called it quits and said the last amen. You showed up just in time, but Lord, you did it again. Amen. You showed up just in time, Lord, you did it again.
Amen. Praise the Lord. God's good, and he shows up right on time. Amen. Hey, you're listening to the Gospel Music Jukebox right here with your host, Evangelist Eddie Chaney. And tonight the topic is the cost of following Jesus. Amen. Have you ever really sat down and just wondered and thought about it? Have you read the Word of God for yourself? Have you read it and then said, oh, am I doing that? You know, I mean, have you counted the cost? Have you thought about why is it that few people follow Christ, you know, for a lifetime? We're talking about a lifetime commitment here. The cost of following Jesus, you see, is what the topic's about. So we'd love to hear from you. Just drop us a line. Amen. Give us a holler. Hey, have you ever thought about why do some people appear to follow for a time and then they fall away? Or what prevents us from following Jesus wholeheartedly? I mean, with everything. Why does many of us prefer to build on sand rather than the rock? Hey, you got to remember, as they were walking along the road, you know, and a man said to Jesus, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus replied, foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has no place to lay his head. Now, you know, I mean, even to another man, he said, follow me, you know. But the man replied, Lord, first let me go and bury my father. Jesus said to him, let the dead bury their dead, but ye go and preach the gospel, the kingdom of God. Can you just imagine? Now, I mean, you think some people's hard today with the Word of God, but if you was walking with Jesus and Jesus said, follow me, and you said, well, first let me go bury my dad, I mean, he'd hurt your feelings, wouldn't he? Well, he's hurting their feelings today. See, people don't want to count the cost of what it is to pick up their cross and follow after Jesus. They want to hold on to just a little bit of the world so they can justify sin. I mean, you know, so you think about it. Still another man said, I will follow you, Lord, but first let me go back and say bye, you know, to everybody in his house, you know, his family. And Jesus replied, you know, no one who puts his hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God. Look in Luke chapter 9, verses 57 down to about 62. As always, I want to encourage you to keep an ink pen, a paper, and pad by you. Always jot down the references and go read the Word of God for yourself and then apply the Word of God in your life. Now, I want you to stop for just a moment, and I want you to think about this, because nothing has changed. Nothing has changed. Jesus is still saved.